Yako Victory Charismatic Chapel. Na yako akuti nyamia sema ebebo ya brabo. Life changing word of God. Any DM coming home na yema papa akwaba na fe yentimi emomo dia inti nyanko pasem. Daddy, mbacho yemo akwaba.
You're right.
I always say it's a DBI. I don't know whether it's your smile. You always new, look new. I think you're looking young every single day. What's that? No, so fatal.
That's it.
Nice. But you have a so.
Yeah, that's it.
But sorry about all day.
Ding,
yeah, then you can see power. Only you see the power. Amen. I'm going to go to the house.
Yeah,
that's it.
Amen.
Papa, nene are na to go to
the house.
Wow.
Afi yasheshia onyamia oti onam jasu tie yam Bible, the God that answers by fire.
Wow.
I've realized that a lot of things are challenging us.
Very true.
But there is a God that answers by fire.
That's true.
And I will explain the meaning or give you the definition of the God that answers by fire.
Fire.
When you feel like life is crushing you, there is a God that answers by fire.
Wow.
Amen.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
I am pretty sure that you are anticipating to hear what this word carries. And Mr. Rao, stick glued to PO95.7. Na Victory Charismatic Chapel. Yesofo Penny, Apostle Franco say, Enchechi mu na yente asem na se. Na yen hu de wea yisi bo abrabonafa. Yemu bi ubre, that papa, yefisa abrabono esi. Oton na ya anto afu yise abewe ye. Amanfo so ma inimwa ye den. But still, nyanko pa ugu so renema. So,
amen.
There is a God that answers by fire. Thank you.
Yeah, that's it. Amen. Well, listeners, this evening we want to thank God for another opportunity that He has given to us. And we are coming your way this evening to share the word of God with you. Today is a special day for me. Because I have one of my sons in the ministry and also in the Lord. And he's a pastor of our church in America. And I have one of my sons again, Pastor Hima. And Mrs. Yeboah. Tonight they are going to join me and we are going to pray for a lot of people. So, Pastor Tony, you are welcome. Pastor Ima, you are welcome. Thank you for standing with us in times like this. For the past weeks, I've been sharing with you how to set free from foundational issues. I share with you, or I gave you the features of foundational issues. And I've also shared with you how to be set free from it. One of them is the power of testimony. Another one is placing a demand on the mercies of God. Today, I want to share with you another vital key that will help you to set free from foundational issues, that is the God that answers by fire. So let's have a word of prayer. Unto thee we ascribe glory and honor and power. Father, give us quick understanding in your word, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Turn with me quickly to the 1 Kings chapter 18.
Then
we'll read from verse 24. This is the account of Elijah that we're facing the prophet of Baal and doesn't know what he has to do, but he turned to God and proved to the prophet of Baal that there is a God that answered by fire. We live in a time that a lot of people think that God is far away from them and he can't answer their prayers. A lot of people think that God delays, so they have to do things to help themselves. But there is a power that will help us to solve problems. So we are going to study the life of Elijah, that when he prayed, God answered his prayer. Each one of us are being challenged from one way or the other. Either your business, your family, your ministry, your leadership, or your nation, there's something challenging you. We see Elijah was challenged by the prophet of